Imagine you have 2,000 euros to spend. Should you rather go for the A7 III or the A7 R2? In this video, we're going to talk about the pros and cons of each camera, and we're also going to talk about the specs and is it actually really worth the upgrade? Because I'm currently using the A6000, which is also a Sony mirrorless camera. So the A7 III has been released in 2018, and yeah, it's a 24 megapixel sensor. And it's also full frame. And the cool thing about the A7 III is that you have 693 autofocus points. So when you're like into portrait photography, yeah, you're really good to go because yeah, the AF is very important because it helps you to really like capture every moment. So that's a huge pro of the A7 III. And what is also good about the A7 III is, so for example, if you're like into sports photography or wildlife photography, you have 10 frames per second, so you have like continuous shooting. And this is also really good because a lot of Sony full frame bodies like the A7 II or the A7 I, they only shoot 5 pictures per second. So this is a huge pro of the A7 III. And you also have a maximum ISO of 51,200, so also a great camera in low light. And if you are, for example, into weddings, which makes the A7 III unique is that it has 2 SD card slots. So when you have like an SD card which is broken on a wedding, you also have a spare one. So this gives you more security and it makes you also more professional because you have like 2 SD cards and you can give, for example, one to the clients and you also can keep one yourself. So it's pretty good to have like these 2 SD card slots. And what also is good about the A7 III is that you also have in-body stabilization. So I use the A6000 and I don't have in-body stabilization at all. And you probably ask yourself, how much is the A7 III? So you get the A7 III for around 1,700 euros, which is really good for such a good camera, which also shoots 4K. And I personally think that's a really good camera for that price. But we also have the A7 R2 on the other hand. And let's get straight into the price. So you can get the A7 R2 for around 1,500 euros if you get it brand new, for example, but only the body. I also saw it like for around 1,200 on like eBay used, which is such a good deal. And what makes the A7 R2 unique is that it is a 42 megapixel sensor. So when you compare that to the A7 III, you have almost double the megapixels. And megapixels are good because then you have better resolution. And another good thing about the A7 R2 is, and when we compare that to the A6000, is it also has a lot of autofocus points. It has 399 in total. And a lot of people say like, oh, the A7 III has like almost double the autofocus points, but I'm currently having just 179 and that's actually so good. So 399 autofocus points are really good for cameras, so don't worry about that. And there's one slightly difference between the A7 R2 and the A7 III is that the A7 R2 only shoots 5 photos per second, so it's like less than the A7 III. So you have to be careful in kind of what photos you want to do. When you just do portrait photography, that's totally fine, but if you do wildlife photography or like sports photography, you have to be careful here because you might end up shooting like not the photo you want. So be sure you always think about how many photos you want to do per second. And what I also wanted to mention is, so what is good, for example, with the A7 R2 is that it uses the same batteries like the A6000. And what is the same like the A6000 is that the A7 R2 has also an ISO of 25,600. So when you, for example, shoot in low light, the A7 III has like double amount the ISO, but on photo shoots, I shoot like 1000 ISO maximum. So don't worry about it. It's so good, like at least like to shoot 25,600 ISO anyway. It's so good for like a camera. So I honestly see this also as a pro. And what is also good about the A7 R2 is that it also has in-body stabilization. So also a good camera if you do handheld shots. And this is a bit different with the A7 R2 is that it only has one SD card slot. And for weddings, you would be definitely fine because I had like over 200 photo shoots now. And here it comes to like organization. that you always organize yourself on photo shoots. So one SD card slot is totally fine if you get the right SD cards, of course. So don't worry about that. So yeah, when we compare these cameras and really look on which one should I get, and I honestly, this is my opinion, I'm also going to do real talk now, is I honestly think I would rather go for the a7 III because 24 megapixels is so good and more than enough, because a lot of photographers, especially beginner photographers, think they should like always get the most megapixels out of their camera. But the problem with 42 megapixels is that you end up with more hard drive space. And on photo shoots, from my experience, I end up editing just 20 pictures. And when I, for example, shoot like 2000 pictures with the A7 R2, I have so much space I don't use. Another reason why I would go for the A7 III is that I personally love shooting in burst mode. With the A6000, I shoot like 11 frames per second. And I think this is something I also want to keep. And if I only shoot 5 photos per second, I might miss the moment from the picture. So I would rather shoot 10 frames per second, and I know I have more pictures then, and I can choose for more. And given a camera which is 24 megapixels and 10 photos per second, I think that's a good combination. So that's also a reason why I would go for the a7 III. But honestly, and this is now real talk, I'm still thinking about upgrading anyway, because I have 24 megapixels and I have a lot of autofocus points. And with my camera, I'm so happy at the moment. And even though if I would have 2000 euros, I would still like invest it more in lenses or just save it for like Black Friday or something. Because there's a saying, and it's called fear of missing out, like FOMO, that the industry in photography, like every company wants you to always gear up and always to buy a new camera. So there's so many cameras out there, and I know it's hard because you see so many YouTubers out there, they have like so expensive cameras, and you also want to be part of that, and you also want to be like them and identify also yourself. And it's also cool to have like a good camera, but you always have to ask yourself, do you really want to spend that a lot of money on a camera? Because 2000 euros is a lot of money. So guys, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I also hope that my message at the end helped you with making a decision or like sticking with your camera. I'm personally, yeah, happy with my A6000, and yeah, it's not the best in the market, but it keeps me still creative and I love it, and all my clients are happy. So guys, if you like this video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel. Make sure to ring the bell so you always get notified when I upload a new video. You can also follow me on Instagram so you can check out my portraits there. And guys, thank you so much again for watching. Take care of yourself and see you next time. Bye.